evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Dr. Amanda Ordonez, Director of Nursing at College of the Mainland in Texas City, Texas. I would like to welcome you to the Spring 2020 first ever virtual pinning nursing ceremony. The nursing pinning ceremony is a tradition that symbolizes the achievement of becoming a nurse and the transition to professional practice. The pinning ceremony represents commitment and sacrifice by the nursing graduates and their families. Graduates, you are amazing. You have not only persevered through nursing school, you have also persevered through the start of a pandemic and a change in our curriculum delivery, as well as a change of the way we live life from day to day. Nursing has always been a dynamic field, and now is a time more than ever for creativity and innovation in the way we holistically care for our community, our nation, and our world.
To all of our 2020 nursing graduates, congratulations on this special day of your pinning. We at College of the Mainland are so very, very happy for you and proud of your accomplishments, and look forward to hearing about all of your work adventures in the years to come as College of the Mainland alumni. This is a especially trying time for us right now, and we need individuals such as yourselves who are stepping out into the front lines to take care of all of us. And the profession that you have chosen is an old and established profession that we can only admire and give undue respect. Please know that everyone at College of the Mainland is proud of you, and let us know now or in the future what we can do to help you and yours during these troubling times moving forward. Again, congratulations on your pinning, and on behalf of College of the Mainland, job well done.
I would like to thank everyone who has assisted our nursing graduates during their time in our program at College of the Mainland. Our faculty, Dr. Deborah Bauer, Mr. Jay Ketcherside, Ms. Nancy Terrio, Mrs. Deborah Bisco Ingram, Mrs. Teresa Henry, Mrs. Deosha Anderson, who is also the ADN and VN Clinical Coordinator, Ms. Terry Davis, Dr. Sandra Rondeau, Mrs. Lisa Hall, Ms. Molly Gunderman, Mrs. Renee Levitt, Mrs. Deanna Machula, Mrs. Pamela Gwynn, Mrs. Sarah Chippewa Garcia, and Mrs. Karen Bell. Additionally, I would like to thank our Board of Trustees and our College President, Dr. Warren Nichols, in the President's Office, Dr. Jerry Flieger, Vice President for Instruction, Dr. Steve Sewell, Dean of Academic Programs, Dr. Carla Boone, Dean of Workforce and Continuing Education, Dr. Vicki Stanfield, Vice President for Student Services, Dr. Chris Kimbark, Dean of Students, Dr. Clint Burton, Vice President for Fiscal Affairs, and Mr. Michael McGee, Director of Human Resources.
Our guest speakers for our ceremony are three heroes in our community. They are also past nursing graduates from College of the Mainland. Ms. Christina Ng, Ms. Bernadette Scala, and Ms. Heather Letty graduated from College of the Mainland Nursing Program in 2017. Recently, they traveled to the epicenter of the COVID-19 battle to assist in care for patients with COVID-19 in New York City. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to welcome Ms. Christina Ng, Ms. Bernadette Scala, and Ms. Heather Letty.
Hello everyone, my name is Christina Ng, and I graduated from College of the Mainland in 2015. First and foremost, I would like to congratulate all of you graduating and taking part of the nursing pinning ceremony today. Nursing school is incredibly difficult, and you made it through. You should be incredibly proud of yourselves, and I know your family, friends, and especially your professors are. I know firsthand how difficult nursing can be, and to continue your studies while a global pandemic is going on is amazing, and I admire all of you so much. So to tell you a little bit about myself, I graduated from the University of Houston with a bachelor's degree in psychology prior to becoming a nurse. After I went to COM and graduated, I worked as a med-surg and telemetry nurse for a few months, and the rest of my nursing career was spent in the ICU. I left the ICU in 2018 and started working in the OR as an OR circulator, pre-op nurse, and a PACU nurse for ophthalmology cases. And I also see patients as a home health nurse several times a week. I'm currently back in school. I am at the University of Texas of Houston and studying to become a family nurse practitioner where I'm pursuing my master's degree. When the crisis hit, I made the decision to go back to the ICU, but I wanted to help in New York. So I am currently here in Brooklyn. I can tell you with all the experience in critical care and trauma that I've had, nothing could have ever prepared me for what I have been dealing with here. Everything I was taught about the management of diseases, especially respiratory ones, and the complications that accompany them didn't seem to matter as much as the core nursing skills that I was taught all those years ago as a nursing student. And by that, I mean showing empathy and compassion at every moment you get, utilizing therapeutic communication and touch every single time you walk into a patient's room, even if they don't seem to respond. We are living in a time where this disease has no bias, and its severity is beyond terrifying, and it's beyond anything I could have ever imagined. Because patients are left alone with no family to be there at the bedside, you are now, more than ever, their voice and their advocate, and you have now become their daughter, their son, friend, and caregiver. My advice to you, as you enter the honorable field of nursing, is to never stop learning and to continue your education after this. But most importantly, take the time to do everything with compassion. Your patients may not ever be able to see their families again, as is the case with so many of my patients here in Brooklyn. So with what time they have, I encourage you to fill their days with love. Always remember that some days are harder than others. And although it may be difficult to do, remember you can only do what you can in the 12-hour shift that you were at the hospital. Someday when things calm down and the world begins to slowly go back to what we remember as normal, if at all, always remember that you became a nurse during a time when you were needed more than ever. That your knowledge and training is what is sought out by so many in the world. I hope and pray that all of you stay safe during this uncertain time in our world, and I couldn't be prouder to speak to all of you today. You are all calm, trained nurses, and I know that you will be exceptional wherever you choose to go. Congratulations again to all of you, and despite our circumstances, I hope you're all able to celebrate safely from home.
Hello, everyone. I am so happy to be here at your pinning ceremony. I know you all have been waiting for this very moment for quite some time now. Congratulations to each and every one of you. My name is Bernadette Scala. I graduated from COM in the year 2017. It sure seems like it was just yesterday. Truly, we all shed blood, sweat, and tears through us all. Take a moment and look at where you are now. I'm so proud of all of you, as I'm sure all the amazing instructors you had are as well. Since graduation, I've held the position of Director of Nursing as well as Chief Nursing Officer. My latest endeavor was responding to the current COVID-19 pandemic in New York City. I felt compelled to help as our brothers and sisters in arms needed relief. I worked for 21 days straight, and I was going to extend for 8 more weeks until I hurt myself on the job. It was heartbreaking being in New York. I will share with you one devastating experience I had while I was there and will forever remain in my memory. My very first COVID patient was in his early 50s. As you know, family members are not able to visit. He was dying. He had all the classic signs and symptoms of nearing death. A nurse had asked me, "Bern, how long do you think he has left?" And I said, "It's probably going to be before midnight." I informed my charge nurse who in turn called the doctor on duty, who had said he doesn't have much longer. Social services came and we called his daughter. She spoke only Spanish. I understood some of the conversation and I surely understood the wailing on the other line. I held my patient's hand through this all. After the conversation was over, I was called to help another nurse at the next bed. I whispered to him that he was not alone, that I would be right back. When I returned, he had taken his very last breath. I cried. After the doctor has pronounced his death, I cleansed his body. I was then given a body tag. I placed the name tags where they should be and wheeled his body to the morgue. I never saw a freezer full of bodies, and my heart just sunk. Mentally, I had a breakdown, sorry. But I had to get myself back together as I had others to take care of for 20 more days. With that story being told, I've always believed that nursing is a calling. As you take your oath today, remember that you all chose this profession. We will have to take risks at times that will put our own health on the line. Practice nursing faithfully. Remember that this is not a bed of roses at all times. Sometimes there are thorns. Stand tall and work through it. You made it here. You can make it anywhere. There are a world of opportunities for you out there. It might take you some time to find the right fit for you. I promise you when you do, you will love what you do. It won't be about having a job. It is fulfilling your duty as a nurse, and you'll love doing it. This is your calling. Never forget where you started. Always do things the right way, even when no one is looking. That's integrity. Once you get your experience, don't ever eat your young. We are all there at one time and one point in our lives. Be proud of what you have accomplished. You did amazing. So congratulations, class of 2020. You did it.
First of all, congrats. You did it. You are the nursing graduates of 2020, the 200th anniversary of the birth of Florence Nightingale, also known as the Year of the Nurse. My name is Heather Lett. I am a 2017 graduate of the CALM Nursing Program. I am an ICU, CVICU nurse, and currently, due to COVID, I am working at Mount Sinai in New York City. What I've learned during COVID is truly so very much. However, what stands out to me is being a nurse of integrity. You will pledge, as I did in your pinning ceremony, to pass my life in purity and to practice my profession faithfully. I challenge you to lead by example, especially in these times. Your community and your family is looking to you to see how you handle things and how you handle yourself. I challenge you to strive for progression and not perfection. Never be intimidated to ask for clarification or to ask questions. You gain your confidence by knowing what you're doing. And sometimes you're gonna have to ask questions. We've all been baby nurses. I'm still a baby nurse of 3 years. If it's our first day on the floor or if we've been on the floor for 50 years, there's always something to learn. Therefore, I'm challenging you to learn something new every day. There's always something to learn. In our career, we will forever be changing. You need to be flexible and you need to be ready to go, ready to learn. Be prepared as best as you can be. Lean on each other. In the darkest of my days, the light at the end of the tunnel for me has been that I can say I have been a nurse of integrity. I challenge you to join me and be a nurse of integrity. you are now my new brothers and sisters. So we need to look out for each other. Again, congratulations. Thank your family, thank your friends. This was no small task to complete this program. And again, I congratulate you and welcome to the front lines.
The Associate Degree Nursing PIN. In the nursing profession, one of the most visible signs of educational growth is the achievement of the nursing PIN, which is worn on the uniform or the work clothes of every registered nurse. The wearing of the nursing PIN is a privilege earned by nursing graduates. It signifies the transition from the role of the student to the role of the practicing nurse. The most recent ancestor of the nursing PIN is a hospital badge of 100 years ago. This symbol indicated the student was educated to serve the health needs of society and was worn as a badge of honor to represent the specific hospital of training. In that same tradition, each nursing school has a unique PIN design. And we would like to take a moment to explain the symbolism that is on what tonight's graduates will receive. The laurel wreath. This encompasses the PIN and is traditionally a symbol of high achievement. A gold circle. This within the wreath represents the continuous professional growth and education that is expected of all nurses. The name of the college. This appears on the PIN as a symbol of pride to be a graduate of the College of the Mainland. The word nursing, which relates to the code of ethics for professional nurses. The lamp. Because of her dedicated service and tireless work during the Crimean War, Florence Nightingale became known as the Lady of the Lamp. The lamp icon is recognized as a symbol of nursing. Light of the lamp is a symbol of care and devotion which nurses administer to the sick and injured in the nursing field. The open book. This further stresses the knowledge essential to the practice of professional nursing, suggesting this knowledge has been acquired by the graduates. The clasping hands. Signifying the caring role of nurses, this is a care that is provided respecting the dignity and worth of every individual.
Yeah, we're proud of you.
We are very, very proud of you. For your accomplishment.
And your achievement.
Thank you.
Congratulations. Thank you.
The Lamp of Knowledge. The nurse's pledge and candlelighting tradition came about as a result of Florence Nightingale's contribution to nursing. Florence Nightingale was an English nurse and pioneer reformer and was born in Florence, Italy in 1820 and died in 1910. Many modern nursing techniques can be traced back to her, including our infection control practices. Florence made history during the Crimean War when she took 38 women to Turkey to nurse the sick and wounded British soldiers. The British government had never before permitted women to do this. Nurse Nightingale carried an oil lamp as she visited and cared for wounded soldiers each night. Because of her selfless duty, she became known as the Lady with the Lamp. As a tribute to her dedication, the lamp icon became symbolic of nursing. The lamp will always shine brightly as a symbol of the care and devotion the nurse administers to the sick and injured in the practice of nursing. And I've never seen this demonstrated more selflessly than with our nursing graduates and our nursing students and staff who have stepped up and done whatever necessary during this COVID-19 pandemic. Nursing students honor the dedication of Nurse Nightingale and symbolically plan to carry the ideals for which she stood in the candlelighting portion of the pinning ceremony. The tradition of candlelighting and the nurse's pledge recognizes her ideals. This tradition has been carried on by the graduating classes since 1893. The pledge is an adaptation of the Hippocratic Oath taken by physicians. There's no evidence that Nurse Nightingale had any input or knowledge of its content. However, it does bear her name. And I now invite you to recite the Nightingale Pledge on your own. And I wish you the best of luck. You guys are going to be great.
I solemnly pledge myself before God
and in the presence of this assembly to pass my life in purity
and to practice my profession faithfully.
I will abstain from whatever is deleterious
and mischievous. I will not take
or knowingly administer any harmful drug.
I will do all in my power to maintain
and elevate the standard of my profession.
I will hold in confidence all personal matters committed to my keeping.
Amen. And all family affairs come into my knowledge in the practice of my calling.
With loyalty will I endeavor to aid
the physician in his work and devote myself to the welfare of those committed
to my care. So help me God.